Hello, Book World. Welcome to the start of a new reading vlog. I have already started to read some books. It is the day after Friday the 13th, so I will kind of call this the Friday the 13th-ish vlog. We're going to go see the movie Saw, but before I do that, I wanted to let you know some books that I read or listened to. An audiobook I listened to, the book Do No Harm. I'd have to give that book 3 out of 5 stars. Writing style was very good. There were some instances where I didn't feel comfortable because there were some racial slurs, and I'm neurodivergent, and there were some instances where they were talking about people that were developmentally delayed, and it kind of made me feel as if they were making fun of them. Maybe it was because I listened to the audiobook. And just because I had that feeling doesn't mean that you'll have that feeling. You may completely enjoy the book. It just wasn't a book for me. The next book that I read was The Bake Shop at Pumpkin and Spice. It is a romance trilogy with 3 different stories in this one book. The first one is Sweet Magic by Donna Kaufman. The second one is Love Spells Disaster by Allison Charles. And the third one is Sweet on You by Kate Angel. I'll have to say that my favorite one was the last story. The second story, I didn't like one of the men in the books. He really ticked me off. So that one kind of upset me a little bit as far as how the guy was treating the lady. But all 3 stories, I would give a 5 out of 5. It is about this magical bake shop, and the 3 stories revolve around this bake shop, the Bella Luna Bake Shop. The owner, Sophia, makes these cookies that are magical cookies that help people fall in love. If you are interested in the person, you will fall in love. It doesn't mean that if someone isn't interested in you, that it'll make you interested in that person, but the cookie will actually speed things along as far as romance. Like I said, it is a cute trilogy, and if you are looking for something lighthearted and cute to read this fall, definitely pick up The Bake Shop at Pumpkin and Spice. I really enjoyed that book. I am also listening to Jar of Heart. I am on chapter 3 of that book. I will have to continue my thoughts on that book once I've finished, but it is about this best friend of this girl who was murdered, and there's a trial and all that good stuff. And it is very interesting so far, so I am enjoying the book. I'm gonna go get something to eat with Shannon, and we're gonna go see Saw.
Close your eyes for a minute, close your eyes for a second. I won't change my mind. What is getting deep now? What is getting deep now?
about to see the movie. We're excited. Hello, we just got back from Saw, and what did you think about the movie? You didn't like it? I liked it. I thought it was really good. It you know, you're gonna have a lot of blood and gore, but the makeup was really good, the effects was really good. And if you watch the movie, you're gonna want to stay till after the credits, because there's a surprise that happens afterwards. But to each his own. Some people may like it, some people may not. If you are a huge horror buff, I think you probably like it, especially if you like the Saw franchise. Hello, I have gotten to chapter 8 on Jar of Hearts, and the book kind of reads so far like the TV show Orange is the New Black. You follow this lady's life as she's in prison, and it is really good so far. I'm still enjoying the book. There's also a scene that is a little troublesome with a bunkmate, and you know, the typical stuff that may happen in prison, so just be mindful of that. But all in all, so far I'm still enjoying the book. I'll let you know as I finish up. So I have finished reading Jar of Hearts by Jennifer Hillier, and I absolutely love this book. I would give it a 5 out of 5 so far. This is actually my favorite thriller of all time thus far. I am looking forward to reading Jennifer Hillier's other works. So, like, I think one of them is called Little Secrets, and I'm excited about that book. So I probably will read that around the holiday, because it does take place around the holidays. But Jar of Hearts is about this girl. Her name is Gio, and this detective named Kaiser. There are dual timelines as well, and the way Jennifer Hillier writes the dual timelines, it's beautiful. The perspectives are from the inside of the minds of the detective and Gio. And Gio is actually the best friend of the girl who was murdered in this book. And she is serving time in prison. So we're getting a lot of information there as far as prison life. And the first part of the book reads like Orange is the New Black, and the rest of it reads like a thriller mystery. It's amazingly written. If you get a chance to read this book, you would not be upset, I'm sure. But make sure you do check out the trigger warnings. There are a lot of SA trigger warnings and trigger warnings for assault, child abuse, among other things. So please, if you go into this book, make sure to read all the trigger warnings. That's with any book that would be recommended to you on this channel. Make sure you read the trigger warnings for the book. I'm going to go ahead and close off the vlog. Let me show you my shirt. It's real Halloween. I'm going to go ahead and close off the vlog. And I am so thankful that you came along with Shannon and me for this journey. And I look forward to more reading vlogs for you in the future. Thank you so much for being a part of our world. We love you guys.